Hey, this is Papa from StreetFighterTradingSystem.com. Alright guys, so we are day 2 of the challenge. Yesterday was Tuesday. So I tried to trade, actually to trade very late in the day. So I will show you the trade that I've taken. As of now, I do see, so I'm looking at some of the results. Most of the people, again, I'm surprised, are positive. If you are negative, don't feel shy to put it. I think, as I said, my expectation is that many people are going to be negative at the end because trading is very difficult. And I think in 1 month is not enough to be able to grasp everything, right? But so I'm very, very surprised that many people are positive. I do see that for now Benke has reached the objective, but he needs to trade 3 days. So my advice to him is maybe not trade the ES for the last day, but if he's smart, he can maybe trade the micro ES. Like that, if he loses, he will lose only probably $5. And he would have still have a third day traded, right? So that's also how you can do if you have to manage your money and you have an objective to do, instead of burning your and making yourself lose. It's better if you try maybe to go on the MES, play one contract and see if you can push your profit higher or not. Okay, the rule is just play 3 days, okay, at least, and then make an objective of $200, okay? Well, anyway, what I want to do, so I'm not going to show you only the trades that I've taken because I've taken only 2 trades, but I'm gonna show you some interesting trades that happened during yesterday, okay? So first things first, as usual, what you need to know, and if you, you remind yourself the dashboard that I created, right, with the statistics. So if I go inside Data Studio, so one thing that you will notice is Tuesday is the worst day to take fail to legged pullback. So one thing that happens very, very often on Tuesday is that TTT is the trade to take. You see here, so if you look at Tuesday, if you take all the fail to legged pullback, you will have only a 68% win rate versus 75 in average for other days. Okay, so this tells you something. It tells you that generally on Tuesday, okay, fail to legged pullback tends to fail. So if this tends to fail, that means you should be looking more for TTTs. Okay, and the reason I think why they fail is because on Tuesday, what happened is that Tuesday is often a congestion day. Okay, so on congestion day, you need to be able to play within a range, meaning shorting from the top or buying from the bottom, okay, of the range. And this is what we'll see. There was many, many opportunities that were TTT that was very good on this Tuesday. So pay attention to it next Tuesday, even though it will not be a challenge. Pay close attention to TTTs rather than fail to legged pullback. Okay, anyway, so let's get started on the review. Okay, so I want to talk about something that happened pre-market first. So this is what happened before the market opened, right? I think this is a very good opportunity. So I usually don't trade before the market open, and I don't trade on the first 5 minutes. Okay, of after market open, because I want to understand the direction first of what's going on. That's why I don't trade on the first 5 minutes, and I don't trade before the open, because in reality it can go anyway, right? Because people are preparing themselves to basically trade. But I do think that the setup was interesting. So what happened is that we had like a 3-hit combo. So what is a 3-hit combo? For those who don't know, it's when I have a 2-legged pullback, okay, which happens over here, then I have a higher low, then I have a fail to legged pullback. Okay, and what I like is when the setup happens within the same swing of the 2-legged pullback. So the swing high of the 2-legged pullback is here. So I want the setup, the 3 setup, to happen with below, okay, this swing, right? And then another thing that makes it good is that we had like the bottom of the range over here. So it tested once, twice, 3, 4 times, And then it did like a SBK type of candle over here, right? A very short SBK. So what you will do is that me, the way I play it is I wait for the price to shoot up, right, above. Then I will place a limit order right here, right? And then I will see what will happen. So one problem on this type of, on this setup is that it does a not sidebar, okay? But normally, since you have your stop 2 points below your entry point, so your entry point is here, okay? Your stop loss is 2 points below, so you will still be able to be a winner at the end, okay? 2 point fix. Okay, so this was the first setup. I think if some people took it, then I think it's a good setup to take because it's a trade combo, SBK candlestick. The risk is low, and it happened within the same swing high, right? So pretty good. Other setup that I wanted to talk about is, so people ask me on the chat, is the two-legged pullback within the challenge? So no, if you take a two-legged pullback, you should not count it within the challenge because we focus on failed two-legged pullback, not on two-legged pullback. But if it's a Pikachu, then yes, because a Pikachu is a two-legged pullback and a failed two-legged pullback, okay? But I still want to talk about this two-legged pullback because I think it's probably the, how to say, the picture perfect type of two-legged pullback that you should be willing to take if you take them, okay? So there is two two-legged pullback that you can take. One is if it's on the range, on the bottom of a range with a hammer candlestick and no opposing STT. And the second one is this type, okay? So this type is what is if you have an impulse, you have a retrace and you see this is my opposing STT and the entry point is here, right? So by the way, you have a SBK candle here also, but I don't know if it works or not for a two-legged pullback, but the entry point is here. And the good thing about this is that the two-legged pullback is going upwards, meaning that here you see this, it's maintaining the upward movement, right? So this is, if you look inside my, how you call it, my lesson two, I also talk about this where I only have one candle that is going higher, right? So go back on the lesson two for those who didn't took it. I explain what are the only two-legged pullback that I take, which is basically no opposing short-term trend line. I have only one candle that does the high, okay? And then I have a good candlestick. And usually what I'm looking at also is if the price can retrace to the 50%. I don't think that it did, but yeah, okay. So it's okay if you take it, but it's not part of the challenge, right? Then came a Pikachu. So I saw someone post on Facebook that he has taken this Pikachu. He treated this Pikachu as, how we call it? TTT, meaning that he saw this Pikachu, he said, oh, I have like a opposing short-term trend line here. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to short on this candle. So why is it not good to do this? But first, because first, the definition of a short-term opposing short-term trend line, it needs to be going downwards, right? Here, you are, this is not an opposing short-term trend line. If it's horizontal like this. It's not opposing, right? This is just a range, the top of the range. When I talk about opposing short-term trend line, it has to be like diagonal, like oblique, like this, okay? Second is, you don't want to basically do counter-trend trading after a first impulse, okay? So this thing, by the way, could be considered as an ABC. That's why you see here, when I saw this, I will draw my measured move and then I will push it over here, right? So when I saw this, okay, I will see this, so I will see impulse A, B, C, okay, and then I will draw my measured move and then put it over here. And I will not try to short before the measured move is done, okay? Because this would mean that you are counter trend. And if you are counting impulse the way I do, this is impulse one, impulse two. So no way you should short on the first, on the second impulse. You should not go counter trend on the second impulse, okay? What you could have done though is you could have went long maybe, but it's even going long is difficult, I will say, because yeah, it seems to be a resistance, but I don't know, maybe with order floor, order book, you could take it, but anyway. Other trade that came is this TTT, so you have a failed two-legged pullback. So this is the two-legged pullback, it fails, and this is the failed two-legged pullback, it fails, and then you had to put your buy stop above this candle. So I think this was a very good trade. Now the concerning part, so it's a bearish bullish setup, but the concerning part is that this candle is quite big, okay? So usually when you have such a green candle, you should try to put like a limit order, but if it goes too fast, so I was speaking with Dean, and he told me that in any case the setup went too fast, that you didn't have the time to place a limit order in any case. So yeah, but if you have the time, don't put a buy stop over here, but try to put a limit order around the middle of the candle, okay? But anyway, so this was a good opportunity. Other opportunity, so this, I actually took this trade over here. You will see it on my trading logs after that, I will show, but basically this Pikachu on the bottom of the range, I have an opposing short-term trend line, right? And as I said to you, what is the main pain point of a Pikachu is when you have an opposing. So I saw the opposing, and then what I did is that I put a sell stop over here. So this was fairly dangerous, by the way. I wouldn't advise it to everyone because it's at the bottom of the range. And what I always say is don't short at the bottom. But yeah, when it was here, okay, I couldn't see that it was at the bottom of the range. I only see one candle, okay? I had the measured move, I had the lower high, okay? So what I'm searching for is to basically take a counter trend trade, okay? Now, the thing is that here it resets. And because this thing goes below the SMA, so this is actually normally only a first impulse, okay? So dangerous, but control, because as I said to you, one thing that I notice a lot is if I have an opposing short-term trend line that is opposing to the Pikachu, most of the time the failed trigger, enfin, the failed trigger pullback that happens will work, right? But dangerous. Another type of setup which I think was better to take, which I took, is this Pikachu. Okay, so as I said, the only normally type of two-legged pullback that I take is if I have basically a short-term trend line, okay, which is not opposing, so it's not opposing over here to the entry point. I have a hammer candlestick that is happening at the bottom of the range, and I have one spike like this, so one candle is going higher. Okay, so again, go into my video lesson, I think two, I explain what are the type of two-legged pullback that I take, okay? And this is a perfect one, and it was a Pika, so very good trade. Here, I think another good trade too, it's the TTT. So happening at the so yeah, I have the two-legged pullback fail two-legged pullback that fails. This candle is happening after one, two, three, four tests, okay, four tests of the upside. So this is the context. So I think that this TTT was very good to take, okay? Third trade that I've taken. So you see over here, so I have first impulse to the downside. Now what I'm looking for is, do I have a failed two-legged pullback? So one thing that I haven't noticed, and I think I don't know what I have done, so let me check. Okay, so yeah, I entered. So I haven't seen that this thing. So it did a failed two-legged pullback, but this was an outside bar. Okay, so normally I should have entered over here, but I don't know why I haven't seen this outside bar. So I entered one tick below this. Okay, so over here, and then the entry point, and then I got stopped with. So it did 1 point, but you know my ATM strategy. So once it does one, my stop loss will go to 50, enfin 2 ticks, okay, and then it came back, By the way, I feel that I was not able to make work the Dean strategy with any runner so far. So I will see at the end of the challenge, maybe I will give up on the Dean strategy. I think that most of the time the price always come back to the to 2 ticks for now, okay? But let me know on the comment section on your experience if you are able to have a runner even with one contract, okay? So this is pretty much what I wanted to share. Yeah, there is a Pika, there is an opposing STT, so I don't think that you should take this type of trade. Okay, I will never take that. What else? Yeah, I took this thing also, but this is the order book, so for trade that I will not talk about. And then yeah. So that's pretty much for the day. One thing that you could have seen also is from an Elliott Wood perspective. Okay, so if I unzoom, if I dezoom a little bit, so this made actually what I call a perfect Elliott wave structure, because I have like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so this is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is my one, and we can see 2 over here, 3, 4. 4 doesn't retrace on the territory of 1. I have my fifth, which is over here, right? Then it does A, B, C over here. Okay, so A, B, C. Okay, then what you can do when you see an ABC is to do the complete measure move from the ABC. Okay, so this will be your. So do I have. What is my arrow shortcut? Okay, this. Okay. And then you report this thing. Let's see, I haven't even checked it. 2 over here. So sorry. Tac. Yeah. So now let's see if the target was reached. So it was not reached as of yesterday, but today you can see where the red candle stopped. It actually stopped right into the measure move of the ABC, right? So we have a big one, ABC, 3, and here is going for the fifth wave, okay? And we'll probably have some retrace ABC. So as I said, the market is, if you are doing swing trading, Elliott Wave is the best technique that you can ever get if you want to get all those big swings move, right? Yeah, maybe what else? Yeah, I want to show you my trade performance. So because after people are gonna say, yeah, what the fuck, you don't post your trade performance. So here I'm at plus $137.50. You can see on my screen what are the trades that I've taken. Yeah, okay. Again, so trading is very difficult. Me, what I expect, okay, is not for everyone to succeed the challenge. I'm doing the review, so I don't have the time to play every day, okay. I try to do it because I think that. If it's a challenge, I need to also set example. But the idea is for you guys to train yourself, right? And you should always try on your side to analyze your trade, log, understand what is working, not working. It is okay if you blow up your account. The idea is to learn. I think about Risky, who has basically shared this performance. I think it's a very good, even if you lose, to share why you are losing, right? We're here to help, we're here as a community. We need to help ourselves. And admitting our mistakes is, I think, the number one rule to understand how to progress. Okay, so please feel free to post your trade on the Facebook channel. I will always take the time to answer. There is also Darian and Dino who basically answers most of it. I'll try to answer tonight at everyone, okay, that took trade or didn't took trade. So yeah, I think that make the effort, as I say. This is for you guys, it's not for me. I mean, I know how to trade. I've been doing this for 2 years, but it's for you to progress, okay? This was Papa from StreetFighterTradingSystem.com. I will probably see you tomorrow.